professors for inviting me on this beautiful conference. And today I want to continue speaking about superinsulator and about difference between superinsulator and usual insulator. Firstly, I want to say about what's mean superinsulator. Superinsulator, this is a dual system to superconductor, but opposite it. Same as superconductor, superinsulator is a non-dissipative system, but they have infinite resistance or the reconductance. And this state was observed in many materials like titanium nitride, niobium titanium nitride, indium oxide.
Alexey, can you move your microphone up onto your shirt?
Okay.
If you put it on your shirt, then it will not make so much noise.
Okay. Here is maybe this is better. Okay. Now, also the state was observed in some artificial network, which consists from capacitance and inductance with right parameter, but I will not speak about it. Okay. What we use? We use titanium niobium nitride films. Here is cross section in high resolution electron microscopy, and here's niobium titanium nitride film. It's enough homogeneously. In plan view, you can see many crystallites with size around 5-6 nanometers, thickness of our film around 8-10 nanometers, depends from sample. And what we see in resistance of this film. Okay, and here you can see temperature dependence of resistance for many samples with different thickness. But and you see here transition between superconducting and superinsulating states. For next experiments, we use only superinsulator films. And firstly, I want to say about this superinsulator states. If we will change in distance between contact, we will see that this superinsulator also changed. For example, okay, in first picture in left upper, we see temperature dependence of resistance for five different distances between contact. And when distance is big, we see good insulator with temperature dependence stronger than activation, like as deeper activation. But when we decreasing this distance between contact, our insulator destroying up to metal behavior with saturation. We can describe this behavior with Polyakov strings and monopoles, about which Carla speaking several days again. But I will not stop on it. Also, the strings effect on current voltage characteristics with fantastic homogeneous of electric field. And other, what we can do with this system? Here we see only behavior at DC current. This is not enough. Let's speak about high frequency behavior. Of course, we can firstly measure capacitance or inductance of our films, and this results was presented several years ago, and there was many problems with measurements because different techniques gave us different results, and there we couldn't understand why. And now we want using impulse voltage and see what's happened with our system. First, unfortunately, doesn't work normally. Okay, then we will see only last picture. Okay, if we using square impulse of voltage, start impulse from 0 second, stop impulse at 50 microseconds. What we see, in first time, several microseconds, we didn't observe any current. And only after time, we see a jump of current to normal value, which we measure in DC measurements. If we will increase in temperature, this behavior will disappear. Unfortunately, this work not very good, and I'm afraid you cannot see it. Animation was broken. Okay, and with increasing of temperature, we can transform our curve from superinsulating behavior to usual insulating behavior with exponential growth of current when we turn on voltage. Okay, let's see what's happen if we will change maximum of voltage in our system. You see here that with increasing of voltage, time between starting of impulse and starting of growth current is decreasing. And if we analyze this behavior, we can plot this picture. Here is time between starting impulse and starting growth current versus voltage shifted by several voltage and in a double logarithmic scale. In this scale, we see linear behavior of our dependence, but here is two different parts, which divided by VC2 voltage. In at lowest voltage, we have behavior with 1/2 power. With voltage higher than VC2, it's changed to 3 divided 4. Why it's happened? There is a long theory. Firstly, we can say that at voltage below VC2, our string will be destroyed, and charges which this string consists moves to different side of our samples, and of course, when voltage is increasing, these charges move quickly, and time is decreasing. then we should think about velocity of phase slips at voltage higher than VC2. But I hope in next maybe conference, Carla or Valerie or Christina will talk about more carefully, and I will not speak about it. Okay. Let's speak about this value VC2 and this value V pro. Let's compare it with threshold voltage for our superinsulator. And here you can see current voltage characteristics for three samples with different degree of disorder, and this arrows shows how changes voltage from zero to maximum value, or from maximum value to zero, and you see here small hysteresis, and VC2 is really upper threshold voltage. And the probe have value less than any of our threshold voltage. And we think this value is comparable with VC1, which we usually cannot observe in our current voltage characteristics, because current there is very, very, very small. Why we observed it in at high frequency? Because we have impulse voltage, okay, with short distance between them. If we will increase in time between impulse of voltage, then then behavior in this area is disappear. For example, at time between voltage around 1 millisecond, we doesn't see anything in this area, but in this area we see usual behavior, same figure, no problem. Okay, and next slide. Showing what happens with system if we change impulse, if our impulse of voltage not between zero and maximum voltage, but between plus maximum to minus maximum. And we see here what's happened. When sign of our voltage is changed, sign of current also change. Value is smaller than before changing sign, but after small time, you can see that current is decreasing, reach minima, and only then again increasing, and reach normal value, which we observed at DC measurements. Why it's happened? Okay, if we again speak about strings, about monopoles, about charges, when we change sign of our voltage, we need firstly reverse our strings, and only then they will move, and current is appear. Okay, as a result, we think that this decrease of current, because we should reverse our charges from different side. And also we can construct similar pictures previously with dependence of this time versus voltage. And also we can find linear behavior in double logarithmic scale, similar from different samples, but theory for this is not here. And really that's all what I want to say today, and thank you for your attention.
Well, thank you very much, Alexey. Are there questions?
Can you make a broader comment on the formation of superinsulating state from microscopic perspective?
Unfortunately, we haven't microscope with temperature below 100 mK. But well, in at room temperature, we didn't see any difference between superconductor and superinsulator.
Thank you.
Well, it depends if I can like make a comment. It depends on what do you mean by the microscopic picture, so to say.
We have a Cooper curse in case of superconductor, right? We have formation of kind of Bose-Einstein condensate of quasi bosons, right?
Yep.
That's behind superconductivity. And if we talk about superinsulators, so what's a kind of foundation? Microscopic foundation of possible superinsulating state.
Okay, yeah, on this level, from the permission of the speaker, I can answer. If you like, do you have a minute to reply?
Can you?
Okay, so basically the, okay, let's call it microscopic picture is as follows. The systems in which we observe superinsulating state are the system which experience superconductor insulator transition. Mm-hmm. If you have such a system, as Carlo described in his talk, there is self-induced electronic granularity. So basically around superconductor insulator transition, the system looks like an array of superconducting droplets which are contained by Josephson links. Now, then you have two competing energies. One is Josephson coupling and another is Coulomb energy if you put additional charge on this superconducting droplet. Now, if Josephson energy wins, then you have a superconductor. If Coulomb blockade is stronger, you have insulator, but if you look at what happens in this insulating phase more attentively, you will find out that this phase is absolutely dual to superconductivity. In a sense that you can show that if you have the system experiencing superconductor insulated transition, there are monopoles which are generated in this system. Mm-hmm. And basically super insulating system is exactly dual to superconductors in a sense that you have condensate of monopoles. And this condensate of monopoles squeezes the Coulomb interaction between charges in exactly the same way as Cooper pair condensate squeezes magnetic field into these filaments, which we call abrikosov vortices. And when you squeeze this electric field into these electric strings, this phenomenon is very well known in quantum chromodynamics. This formation is called Polyakov strings, and this exactly this Polyakov strings which prevent charges from moving. This is the phenomenon which is absolutely indeed identical to what is very well known as quark confinement in hadrons. So you have this electric string which keeps charge and anti-charge together and they cannot move until the string breaks. which happens at finite temperature. And therefore, in a finite temperature interval, you have the state with infinite resistance or zero conductance, mirror image of superconductivity. So this is the microscopic picture.
Thank you for a very excellent explanation. Thank you.
I would like to ask you about expression for the calculation of conductivity in such systems. As I understand, you use a ballistic regime of calculation conductivity. What is the reason?
I can't say because I'm not a theorist.
I have a question for you. On your slide 10, could you go to your slide 10, please? Yeah, this one. So you fit your power law to several different exponentials here, but each exponential is a rational number, and you typically only expect rational numbers coming up when you have a mean field theory. So I was just curious why you stuck to rational numbers rather than any number.
Theory predict one half only for voltage between VC1 and VC2, and happens.
If I can also make a small comment on that from you again, permission. Okay, basically what is shown with this one half scaling, this is basically the first ever experimental observation of this Polyakov string. Mm-hmm. Because if you go to this like quantum cryodynamics papers, you will read like, okay, tons of like material explaining why it is impossible to exercise an experiment where you can see this quark motion. What is happening here in this small, okay, small voltages above the threshold is that basically you pull stronger the string, and since the potential is linear, then actually this is like, okay, eighth grade elementary mechanics calculation, which shows that it should be one half just because of the linear tension of the string. And what concerns, okay, the reason that like, okay, other rational powers were chosen, that's because, okay, since you have this like, again, linear string tension, but okay, you apply, okay, higher force, there are some scaling considerations which are still hypothetical, but which produce exactly, okay, this kind of rational numbers, but this is a little bit premature to, like, need a little bit more work.
Thanks. We should thank our speaker and move on to the next speaker again.